Murfreesboro, Tennessee, and he's given us some information in reference to his background, education, and some of his experiences. But he's also willing to talk about some of the other aspects of Islamic life in the state of Tennessee. And Imam, let's have you to talk about more specifically some of the recent activities that have occurred in the state legislature, in the General Assembly at Tennessee, in Tennessee, dealing with some efforts, evidently, to impose some kind of restrictions upon Islamic law. Let's talk about it from that perspective.
Well, it seems like I did watch this closely and I participate in some of this hearing, and it seems like we have to clarify a few points. Mm. Let us all agree that we must care about the state as well as the country, and each one of us wants to be safe. Mm-hmm. So nothing is wrong with us trying to be safe, and this is an ultimate goal. We hope we can achieve it peacefully. But what disturbing is, I heard the term Sharia law a lot, while people saying the Muslims wants to Sharia law to dominate not only the state but the entire country. And I did ask myself, did any Muslim in Tennessee ask for this? Did any Muslim in the state of Tennessee said to anyone in our administration, I want Sharia law to dominate the state? No one said this. And it seems like it's a personal agenda for someone, a group or a party or individual, trying to scare the people within the state, saying the Muslims are trying to do this and that. And they are taking advantage of a few issues, like the Muslim do not, the people do not understand the term Sharia law. Sharia is very much the way of life, while Islam teach Muslim to practice their life properly. But they have a specific understanding to such a term. They will say, you know, Islam have this discrimination between male and the female. And we have, I said before, we have abuse centers in America, while females can report abuse. And all of them very much are false. How many of the people there are Muslim? And why don't you ask any of our females? I'm not saying the Muslims are perfect, but obviously they are people. I believe the majority of them are fine. While people are saying in the, I participate in the hearing last Tuesday, and while some of the people are saying, you know, the bill they want to pass in Tennessee, it is not against Muslims. Why did they allow someone to talk only almost for 30 minutes about Muslim wants to kill the non-Muslim and trying to bring verses from the Holy Quran as well as some stuff from the religious background? And he said he knows Islam very well and he become a scholar of Islam. And it seems like so many people are becoming a scholar of Islam, and I want people, the average people sitting at home, to use their common sense. Muslims have been around for a long time. They are not a new people, nor a small group of people. When we mention Muslims, we must realize that we are talking about 1.6 billion. Yes, this is a very large number. And in the Middle East, as well as the Far East, you can find so many countries while the Muslims are the majority, the extreme majority in so many cases. And they did not destroy any of the churches. You can find some incident happened here and there, but not up to extent. And if the Muslims are supposed to kill the non-Muslim, why didn't they kill them? While Islam allow us to marry from the non-Muslim, from the Christian and the Jewish. I enjoy it's a time when Ivy and I will go to Texas and we sit around the table in Thanksgiving. And my in-laws all are not Muslim. All of them, I love them so much and they love me a lot. And we enjoy eating this turkey together. There is no killing there. It seems like people assume that they understand Islam. And if they want to understand it, we welcome dialogue and we welcome us sitting together, trying to understand each other religion. Nothing is wrong with this. But to feel like, you know, Islam hurt females, Islam does not. Islam actually protected them a lot. And you can ask our females. And it seems like we have to differentiate between some culture exists in some countries and the rules of the religion. And we have to get rid of the stereotype. I understand the September the 11th is horrible, but, and we spoke against radical people. It seems everyone now is talking about radical Muslim, and I am fine with us talking about against radical Muslims. But I want everyone to talk about radical Christian and radical Jewish and radical Hindu and radical atheist. We have as a people. to work together against any radical of any kind. I did not stereotype Baptists because of something happened in Oklahoma. I did not do this. I did not speak against the Catholic Church because some people within the Catholic Church did something with the children. I did not do this because I understand that we are people. Some people aren't that good, but fortunately the majority are good. I cannot stereotype people in America because some Americans did this and that. We cannot do this, otherwise we will hurt ourselves. It's important to remind ourselves that America is so special, so special country, and we are proud of ourselves being American. And I often said in the mosque while I am talking, I am proud of myself being an American Muslim. Why? Because America is so special. America is the only place, at least we can claim, that you can do anything you want, and within the line of the law, and with the respect of the constitution. Why some people wanna take this away from America? Why some people wanna take away from America its liberty and its freedom? While they are saying this bill is not. The bill is not against attack the Muslim community. Why did they spend the fine time talking about the Islam and the Muslim community? They did not bring any other. They did not bring any other religion. It's obvious that it is a discrimination against the Muslim community. We are willing. We did in the past work with our official. We work closely with the FBI and the Homeland Security, and we respect our officials in the state because we want the state to be safe. But we cannot. I don't think it's a proper to have people making lies about other people, and everyone is claiming I'm a scholar in Islam. A scholar in Islam. Okay, if you are a scholar in Islam, you can find probably we can hire you to be an imam in an Islamic center then. And the Muslim community being hurt a lot. Our kids being called terrorists in the school.
Very good. It's having an impact more than just on the center. And there's just been quite a controversy in reference to the.
Yes, and it is not a proper. It is not a proper to give a girl walking wearing a scarf bad names. Why? When I watch nun walking by, I respect her because I feel like she is working for God. She decided to have all of her life for God. I respect her, and I think we must respect her as well as anyone respecting her religion. Why do I? Is it a proper to give a child the bad name? It is a discrimination. People say it's something exists in America. It happened with the African American community. It happened with the Catholic community. It happened with the Jewish community as well. Fortunately, I think all of this will go in the same place in the history.
Let us take this second commercial break. And then we'll come back and talk about other things. And of course, we'll be back to follow this very, very short commercial break.